Subscribe to Hello Wiki. And press bell icon to get latest video notifications.
Hello friends, welcome to Hello Wiki. Today our topic is about Bob Dylan. Bob Dylan is one of the most influential singer-songwriter of the 20th century, known for songs that chronicle social and political issues. Folk rock singer-songwriter Bob Dylan was born on Robert Allen Zimmerman on May 24, 1941 in the Duluth, Minnesota, while attending college. He began performing folk and country songs, stuck into the name Bob Dylan in 1961. Dylan sang his first recording contract and emerged as one of the most original and influential voices in American popular music. Dylan has continued to tour and release a new studio album, including Together True Life, Tempest Shadow in the Night, and Fallen Angels. And legendary singer-songwriter has received Grammy Academy, the Golden Globe Awards, as well as the Presidential Medal of Freedom and Nobel Prize for the Literature. Folk rock singer-songwriter Bob Dylan was born Robert Allen Zimmerman on May 24, 1941 in Duluth, Minnesota, to parents Avraham and Britt Zimmerman. He and his younger brother David were raised in the community of Hibbing, where he graduated from the Hibbing High School in 1949. Driven by the influence of the early rock star like Elvis Presley, Jerry Lee Lewis, and the Little Richard, the young Dylan formed his own band, including the Golden Crows, as well as a group fronted under the pseudonym Elliston Goodwill, attending the University of Minnesota in Minnesota. He began performing the folk and country song at local cave, taking the name Bob Dylan. In 1960, Bob dropped out of the college and moved to New York, where his daddy, the legendary folk singer, was hospitalized with a rare hereditary disease of the nervous system. In 1965, Dylan scandalized many of his folky fans by recording the half-acoustic, half-electric album, Bringing It All Back Home, back in nine-piece band. And July 25, 1965, he was famously booed at the Newport Folk Festival when he performed electrically from the first time the album that allowed a Highway 61 revisited, which including the seminal rock song like a Rolling Stone and the two records at Blunders and the Blondie. Representative Dylan had this most innocent within his unmistakable voice and unforgettable lyric. Dylan brought the world of music and literature together as no one else had. Over the course of the next three decades, Dylan continued to reinvent himself. Following a near-fatal motorcycle accident in the July 1969, Dylan spent almost a year recovering in cellulose. His next two albums on Wesley, including All Long Watch It Over, later recording by the guitar great Jimmy and the unabashed Lee Country's Nashville Cycling, were far more mellow than his earlier work. Critics blasted the two records at Self Portrait and the Tarantula, a long awaited collection. And coming to his personal life, in addition to Bass, Dylan was one point romantically linked to another single, gossip icon Mavis. Through the two never took the trip down the LS. Dylan Flanders, who was married in 1965 and divorced in 1977. When he is not making music, Dylan explored his talent as visual artist. His painting appeared on the cover of his album Self Portrait and Plant Leaves, and he was published several books of his painting and drawing, as well as exhibited his artwork around the world. So guys, this is my story today. If you like my channel, please subscribe for more videos. Thank you.